Well, we're back on Black Ops 3 with the other weapon that was released recently, and that is the LV-8 Basilisk. I like the name. I don't know why LV-8. I'm sure there's a story behind that. I just like the name Basilisk. It's like, yeah, badass weapon, mythical creature. It's gotta be good. All right, well, I ain't gonna challenge this guy. He's just gonna hide from me. I can't really do anything about it. Let's hide under here, actually. Let's not push him. I'd like to, but because this is not an SMG, I just don't trust it. I know it's a really high rate of fire weapon, but the charge time kind of counteracts the high rate of fire. It's like, okay, cool, I can shoot quickly, but I have to be able to predict where he's going to be and start charging my weapon. Looks like he's already behind us, so I got to go forward now at this point. We're going to hide in here now. My team all got cleaned up by one guy in the back, basically. So, I don't know where to go at this point. I need to defend A and B. There's a guy that was flanking us. He's not dead yet, the Eagle guy. There's one player on my right, you can hear him jumping, who threw this initially. He might push in here. I don't have awareness, so I can't hear anything right now. I'm using Dead Silence Blast Suppressor. Well, we're gonna go for this. I have no idea if this will work out well. I don't believe that this is probably a better gun than the VMP, but whatever, you know? Got one. Got two. In front. And there's the third. I could barely hear his little footsteps. If you want to think of this gun, it's probably related to, like, the P06. It has a charge time, but it's not a burst weapon. The P06 is a burst. This is a fully auto with the charge time. It's essentially a reverse HLX4. If you watched the most recent video I did showing the HLX4, which is like the new SMG in this game, the HLX4 shoots instantly, but if you let go of the trigger, it has like a cockback almost. This is a gun that does not shoot instantly. It has a charge time at the start, but it doesn't have a cockback at the end of the fire shot, like the firing sequence. So it's kind of a reverse version of that. It's also not a great ranged weapon. Although it's a rifle, it's definitely better for close range gunfights because of the fire rate. The fire rate is so high, it will match a lot of the other SMGs in the game, but you do not want to do close range gunfights with SMGs typically, because the VMP is still a better gun. It's just, bottom line, that's what it is. It is a better weapon. The VMP is almost unmatchable, in honesty. The HLX4 might have a good chance against it. I've never tried it. But with that kind of fire rate and the overall SMG strafe speed, it makes it really hard to challenge the VMP. Where's this player at? Pause. Okay, he's in the far, far back. Best option for me, honestly, is to go A. Arm it on a sightline that's relatively open. I don't need it to be super open, but just a little bit. Really hope he's... Oh, he's here. Oh my god, he didn't check the bomb. He didn't check the bomb. Should have checked it. He would have had me easily. I have all my streaks now. I gotta, like, start using them before I overlap. Really, you want to treat this gun as an aggressive rifle because of that fire rate, but you don't want to try... You want to try to avoid the SMG challenging. So don't push corners as much. Don't be the player to push the corner. That's like the main thing to think about here. Because the VMP will beat it. It's just, bottom line, it will. It sucks. That gun's so good, still. It just can't really be challenged. It's a close-range rifle, just not close enough and good enough to beat the best SMG in the game. And because of that, you just want to watch out for it. Let's call this in. Here we go. That looked like a good spot. That clears the path for me. I can push up. I'm not sure where they're at, but I'm not going to go down there. So let's go up top. Well, I'm not sure where they're at. They push up to B all the way. Looks like they did. Gotta get here quick to help my team out. On your team, bro. Watch behind you. Hello. There are way too many people left right now. This sucks, dude. Positioning's really bad right now. He has a shock charge up there. I guess I can kind of be a little bit less scared of that spot. All right. Well, he's watching our flank. I'm gonna watch the front right now. We're kind of locked in. The player that was in the water, I'm afraid he's on top right now. And the only way to avoid that, really, is to sit here and waiting to see if he pushes the bomb site and arms it or tries to. I'm gonna try to stop him, obviously. Another thing to mention about this gun is because of the high fire rate, you really want to rock like quick draw stock on it. I'm removing quick draw to try high caliber because any high fire rate weapon with high cal is usually pretty good. A great. Oh, I'm dead. One more there. There he is. This is bomb right there. And he came up top. That's unfortunate. They were all three on the front. Well, teammate, I believe in you, low life. Nice, buddy. Nicely played, sir. Any high fire rate weapon usually benefits a lot from high caliber because just with so many shots going out from it, if one of them hits the head, the multiplier is so crazy on high cal, you just want to run it. I mean, you'll see that. Like if the VMP, imagine the VMP with high cal or the Vesper. Like, it's crazy, right? Some guns you want to run it on anyway. Like, you know, Man of War is not bad. M8's obviously very good. But I think, personally, with high fire rate weapons, high cal pays off a lot. I use it all the time on the HVK. Well, I did when I was playing this game. I'm going to camp back for a minute and throw my little drone out here. Please don't trap me in a corner. I get it, dude. You're a teammate. You're a fan. Just start playing the game and actually help. People are just... I can never just play games for fun nowadays, man. It's so difficult. Ooh, we hit him! That was good. All right, let's go back this way. We got to defend ourselves here. All right. I'll take that. I saved myself. Because, you know, solid squad of teammates we always get whenever playing games nowadays. Guys, come on. Please. I got it. Okay. Well, shout out to the three people that got a kill. I mean, you guys think I'm over-exaggerating the team balancing. It is unbelievable how bad it is nowadays. It's unbelievable. Like, sometimes I play so aggressive, I get all the kills. That wasn't the case. That was, like, last left every round. It's just, I don't get what causes it to be so fucking terrible. I don't remember it being this bad in MW3, in MW2. I played with friends back then, but I played solo a good amount, too. I never remember having to carry this hard in games to just get a win. It's nuts. Thankfully, we had the Basilisk to help us get the W, though. It was a good game for that gun. So this map works out pretty well, decently mid-rangey, you know? It's not bad in any way. Don't use it super long lines of sight. I can't talk. Do not use it on super long lines of sight because you're going to lose to M8s and snipers, guaranteed. You can't burst this weapon. Same as the HLX, you can't burst one, like any weapon that has like a charge time like that or a cockback time after the shot. So don't do that. That's your main thing. And when you get super close range, do not challenge the SMG players unless they have a bad SMG. If they have a Vesper, if they have a VMP, they will beat you. Their guns have no charge time, so they have much quicker reaction time and be able to shoot quicker. And their guns do a lot of damage close range. So despite this fire rate being sick, despite it having high caliber, you do not want to be the player to charge in and challenge the VMPs. You kind of want to back up and put them in a little bit of a mid-range kind of fight. Being too close just equals bad luck, usually. You're gonna die. Not bad luck, it's a bad play, but you die anyway, you know? That's the point. Hope you guys enjoyed, though. Another little day of BO3 with one of the new weapons, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye!